Now we'll discuss C problem of development of surfaces. Problem number 2. A cone of base diameter 60 mm and height 70 mm is resting on its base on HP. It is cut by a plane perpendicular to VP and inclined at 30 degrees to HP. The cutting plane bisects the axis of cone. Draw the development of its lateral surfaces. This is the statement of our problem. Now this problem is simple. What is which solid is given? Cone. Cone is having base diameter 60 mm and height 70 mm. This is resting on its base on HP. So this cone is resting on its base on HP. Diameter 60 mm and height 70 mm. Then it is cut by a plane perpendicular to VP and inclined at 30 degree to HP. This 30 degree inclined plane, it can move anywhere on the axis, but the cutting position is given that cutting plane bisects the axis. That means 70 mm bisect means 35 mm. So this cutting plane, this is the cutting plane which makes angle 30 degree and intersection point is bisecting the axis, means at the midpoint of axis. So draw the development of its lateral surfaces. So after understanding the correct position of cone and cutting plane, your next task is draw orthographic views. So top view of this cone is a circle of diameter 60. So you have drawn a circle with diameter 60. Then divide this circle into 8 equal parts or 12 equal parts, whatever it may be. But draw these divisions and name them as A, B, C, D, like this, G, H. Now you have to draw a projection to complete the front view. Front view of this cone is a triangle. So draw this triangle, and the projection of this A point is A dash on base. Then projection of B and H, they will be B dash, H dash. Projection of C and G, C dash, D dash, C dash, G dash. Then projection of D and F, D dash, F dash, and projection of E as a E dash. Then you set a cutting plane. Now, before that, you join the apex point with the all points on the base. Okay. So these OA or OE, O dash, E dash, they are called as the generators of a cone. How many generators you are drawing in top view? 8 generators. So you have these 8 generators on in front view also. Then you set a section plane. So this is the section plane which is inclined at 30 degree and it bisects the axis. So let us mark a point at 35 mm and draw a section plane at 30 degree inclined to HP. And then next task is you have to mark the intersection of these cutting plane with the number of generators. So let us name this point as a 1 number point or 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, then or you name B for B 2 dash, C 3 dash, D 4 dash, E 5 dash, then A B C D D E F 6 dash, then G 7 dash and H 8 dash. So accordingly all 8 points of intersection of cutting plane with 8 generators you have marked. Then next is you have to draw the development of this cone. Now by radial line development method. So radial line method is used to draw the development of cone. For the cone, you have to calculate the angle theta, included angle theta, and for that formula is theta is equal to radius of base divided by true length of generator into 360. Now radius of base is 30 and this dimension you have to measure. OE dimension, OE is parallel here in top view, that's why this indicates the true length of generator. So measure this dimension, it is 76 into 360, you will get 142 degree as an included angle of arc on which you have to draw the development. So let us mark O dash point anywhere, O point anywhere, and with the radius equal to true length of generator, this true length, you draw a arc. On this arc, this angle is on this arc. You have to take angle as this your 142 angle, 142 degree angle. This angle you have to divide into 8 parts. So that 8 part, whatever is the single division, so you take that single division, and this distance you, this single division, you take this distance in your compass and mark next division. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Well, similarly, you draw this and you name this as A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and again A. Okay, so up to this, this figure is restricted up to this point. So you draw with dimension. So this is not, this may not be with dimension, but you draw with dimension. Then you draw all generators here. And next task is you have to pass the points on respective generators. So point here, only this OA generator and OE generator shows the true length, and other generators are not showing their true length. So other points you have to transfer on either OA or O dash E dash. So 1 dash you can take a distance one here, so one here, and with this O1 distance one here, but this 2 dash point you have to transfer it here. So 2 suffix 1, so you take 2 suffix 1 distance, that distance, and you transfer 2 number point on B. So 2 number point, then 3 number point, you can shift it here, 3 number point on its true length. So 3 suffix 1, so 3, take this distance, and 3 point is on here, so 3 number point. Then 4 number point you shift on D, it you can shift here, so take that distance, 4 number point, 4. Then 5 number point, it is a true distance, so 5 number point, you take 5 on E. Then 6 number point is on F, so that 6 number point you here it is, so you will shift here, take that 6 number point distance, so 6 number is here. Then 7 number point, now this 7 number point you have to shift, 3 and 7 are at same distance, so 3 and 7, so with this 7 number point. And 8 number point is here, so 2 and 8, so at what distance 2 is there, so 8 is at same distance, 8, and last this 1 number point. So all these points you have marked, now you have to draw arc passing through these all points. And only the outside edges and the base, you have to make dark. This is the development of, this figure indicates the development of lateral surfaces of a cone. So development of cone. Or completed cone. So here the problem is simple, but only thing is you have to calculate this theta angle, radius of base divided by the true length of generator into 360. That angle you have to divide into number of divisions, say 8 or 12. Then you mark those divisions, mark the points on cutting plane and the generator, transfer those points on true length of generator, transfer that point on development, and you will get join all points with curve. The figure indicates, or the figure which you have got, is called as the development of a cone. So this is our problem number 2. So all you have to draw this with dimension, with all the equations in a sketchbook, and after that, once you get a finalized solution, clarification from my side, you can draw it in on sheet.